Tanya spoke of.
And we're going to spend 150 grand just to make something we want to see.
That music blaring interrupted a TDSB parent subcommittee meeting on race and equity. Those on the Zoom call say it was a coordinated attack that was meant to silence them. A report has been made to Toronto Police as the Toronto District School Board is now investigating.
Somebody has infiltrated the room and utilized their technological skills to try to undermine what we're talking about. And I'm so glad they did that. I thank you for doing it.
A series of interruptions during a Thursday evening conversation on equity and racism impacting Black, Indigenous, and students of color in the TDSB.
It was a TDSB Zoom account that was being hacked and bombarded.
Over 16 interruptions in the span of over 20 minutes, overtaking the screen and playing a series of loud Guns N' Roses songs over the speakers.
This was a clear example of the oppression that is happening. And in one way, as much as I'm so upset about it, but at least it tells me that when you have that much enemies, you're doing the right thing.
Though this was an event organized by the Claire Leah School Council Equity Subcommittee, it was open to those outside the Scarborough school boundaries, with the link posted online for people to join.
This was planned, right? This wasn't just, oh, I happened to come across this thing and I'm going to be silly. It definitely was, you know, a way of trying to disrupt and silence a conversation about a topic that's really important.
Panelists, including Tanya Hale, say despite this being a digital attack, it wasn't just a prank. It was still coordinated, targeted, and dangerous.
It's still an attack. It's still violence. Just because it didn't physically impact people doesn't mean that it doesn't have an emotional impact.
The TDSB is sending this letter to parents notifying them about the incident, part of it reading, quote, "While the identity of those who interrupted the meeting is unknown, this incident was reported by school staff to Toronto Police. We also took immediate steps to block the individuals from joining the meeting and from sharing their screens."
Knowing now what I know and knowing that there was some issues beforehand, then I absolutely think that it was a planned attack.
This was the group's first seminar focused on anti-Black and Indigenous racism affecting students. And despite the interruptions, the discussions continued.
Nothing like this will silence us. This is just the beginning, and we will talk about it more. We will do, doesn't matter what comes our way, because this is a conversation that needs to happen.
The chair tells me that this subcommittee was initially started after a person of color asked about equity issues at a parent council meeting and was then silenced. This group was then created to give a platform to these discussions, and it is supported by the school and the superintendent. In Toronto, I'm Faiza Amin for City News.